Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today in this video I am going to show you how to install DevC++ on a Windows operating system. And after that I am also going to show you a demo Hello World C program and how to run that within our DevC++. So this video is going to be very informative, I can say. You need to watch the video till the end and you will be able to learn a lot of new things, that's a guarantee from my side. Alright, so everything that you need to learn about DevC++ and how to run C or C++ programs within DevC. So that is what I'm going to discuss on this video. So you have to watch the video till the end, right? And if you face any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. So now to install DevC++, the first thing that you need to do is you need to open a browser. You need to just simply type over here DevCPP and you need to hit enter. So when you do that, you'll be able to see this DevC++ download. So let's open that. So when you open that, it's going to redirect to the official site of SourceForge. So this link I'm going to put right in our description. So you can directly use that link to land over to this DevC++ official site. And here you can see that we have this download button. So you need to click on that. So when you do that, it will again show you that your download will start shortly. And there you go, you can see our download is directly began, right? So DevC++. So once it gets downloaded properly, you need to just simply click on the installer and it's going to start installing it locally on our system. So it will first ask you about the administrative privileges. You need to just simply click on yes, and let's minimize our browser. So you can see, please wait while setting up, while setup is loading. So here you need to select one language. So you can see they have given a lot of language. You can select any of the language from here. I'm going to select English. I'm going to click on OK. So this is our license agreement. So you need to, you know, have time, you can always read this. Then you need to click on I agree. And here you can see that they have given some checkboxes, right? So here the most important part is this TDM GCC. So the GCC, TDM GCC 4.9.2 is basically our compiler. So whatever program that you are going to write within our DevC++, so that program will actually going to be, you know, interpreted by this compiler GCC. So that's why it is very important to download the right software. So that's why I'm making this video, right? As many of my students are keep on telling, like, sir, I have downloaded DevC++ or code blocks, but it is showing error, like why my code is not getting compiled, right? That's what happens when you don't have compiler. So here you can see that TDM GCC is selected, right? So that's a compiler. That is what you need to run any C or C++ program, right? A compiler. So that's why it is very important to, you know, select this one and all the other options also, and to just simply click on next. And here you can see that our destination folder is properly selected. So here our DevC++ is going to be installed. So just, you know, simply click on install. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that it is properly telling that completing the DevC++ 5.11 setup. So also this run DevC++ 5.11 is properly selected. And here also you can see desktop shortcut is also created. So everything is working as per expectation. So you need to just simply click on finish to launch our DevC++. And you can see that DevC++ first time configuration is also properly open. So default language they have selected is English, which is our original language. You can choose any other language from this drop down. Alright, that is totally your wish. So you need to just simply click on next over here. And you can see that the default font they have selected is Consolas. You can choose any of the font. So let's say you are choosing this one, you can see that it is showing like this, right? So this is a bit odd. So I'll go back to the Consolas itself. So which is another default font. You can change the color as well. You can change it to Twilight. So that's going to be, you know, show you a bit dark. So which is generally developer choose. You can choose to Visual Studio as well. You can choose Classic Plus, whatever you want, right? So that is totally your choice. So and here from icon you can choose any of the icon like Genome or Blue or New Look, whatever, right? So yeah, just wanted to show you about all those configurations stuff. So after, you know, doing all that, you can just simply click on next. So then just simply click on OK, and there you go. You can see that our DevC++ is properly opened over here. So here again, you can see the most important part is the compiler. The TDM GCC 4.9.2 64-bit release is the compiler that is properly selected over here. That's a very important part. So if you have that, then you just know that our compiler is properly there, right? So you can safely write your code, you can safely run that, and if your code have any issues or anything, that will be properly going to interpret and going to throw you that sort of error, right? So that's why it's very important. So you know, once you are here, you need to just simply click on file and hover over new and click on source file. So that will open a untitled source file. So let's first go to file again, click on save as, and name this file as, you know, hello world, right? I'm going to save that. So our hello world.cpp file is properly selected over here. So here, so let's write a sample hello world C++ program. So hash include io stream, and then I'm going to create int main method, sorry, int main, and I'm going to open a parenthesis, and first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to return 0. Why you need to return 0 is because it is a int main, so it needs to return some integer type, so that's why you're returning 0. And here I'm going to give std colon colon cout, and I'm going to just, you know, do hello world over here, end with semicolon and then quote, and that's all, right? So now you need to just simply click on this button to save this program, and you need to click on this compile and run, and immediately can see that it is throwing some error, right? That error io stream, no such file or directory. So that error is actually coming because we have a compiler, so it is properly reading our code and it is telling where we have issues. So here if you see that this io stream spelling is completely wrong, so we have a small typo of a, right? So that a was missing. So now if you give that a and click on save, and you again click on this compile and run, immediately you can see that output, right? Hello world is coming. So errors is 0, warning is 0, but you can see the output. So again, this output is actually coming because we have a compiler. So that's why it is very important to have compiler, right? Without compiler, only IDE will not give you, you know, not going to run your code, right? So that's why the, you know, whole purpose of making this video. So in this way, you can easily install DevC++ along with our TDM GCC compiler on the Windows operating system. If you face any issues in the middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.